previous videos we are just going through the chapter number 4, that is rational number. Okay, in that we have just studied up to the 4B question number 8, and now question number 9, that is find 5 rational numbers between question exercise 4B question number 9. In that we have to find the 5 rational numbers between minus 5 upon 7 and minus 3 upon 8. So that you have to do according to this here. An example is given. We have solved, see here, example number 14, that find 3 rational number between minus 3 and minus 4. Okay, and in that way you have to also find the rational numbers, see here, 3 by 4 and 1 by 2. In that you can see, first of all you have to take the LCM, and so for the LCM of 7 and 8, what we have to do, we are taking the LCM. Okay, but here the LCM that will be 2, 7 as it is, 2, 4 za, 2, 2 za, 2, 1 za, and 7 will remain as it is. Okay, so 7, 1 za, 7 at last. Okay, so our LCM is 2, 2 za, 4, 4, 2 za, 8, 8, 7 za. What will be the 8, 7 za, 7, 7 za, 14, and 7, 8 za, 50. 6. So LCM, that is 56. Okay. Now let us see that for the LCM 56 here, what should I multiply with 7, then I will get 56, and what should I multiply with 8, then I will get 56. Then if I will say 7 8s are 56 and 5 8s are, okay, if we have multiplied here in the denominator, we also have to multiply in numerator. Okay, and here 8 7 the, here also 7, so 5 8s are 40, so minus 40 upon 56, and here minus 3 into 7, so that is minus 21 upon 56. So here you can, we have to write any of the 5 rational numbers, but we can write 19 rational numbers between this. Why? We can write the here minus 21 upon 56, 22 upon 56, 23 upon 56, 24 upon 56, 25 upon 56, 27 upon 56, 28 upon 56, up to minus 40 upon 56. But here you can see, I will take minus 40 upon 56. It is bigger or smaller than this? This number is bigger or smaller than this number? Then this one is smaller, okay, and then here I will write minus 39 upon 56, okay, and then after minus 38 upon 56. In that way you can write up to minus 21 upon 56. From this between, you can write any of the 5 rational numbers which we have to write here in the question number 9. Okay, question number 10, you have to do like this, okay, that you have to do in your homework. And now we will move to our new topic, that is addition of rational number. Okay, addition of rational number. In that, see here, when the denominators are same, when denominators are same means this and this both are same, Okay, here you can see the denominator is not same. Here you can see the denominator is same. Okay, students, so let us see that. First of all, you write down this. Okay, have you written? Here, addition of rational number. Addition of rational number. Okay, so here the example number 16 is given, that add 3/8 and 4/8. Example number 16, that is add 3/8 and 4/8, where you can see the denominator is same. Okay, so first of all, what we have to do, when the denominators are same, we can also do this with number line and also with the method. So first of all, we will do with number line. So here there are eight parts. So if I start with here with 0, if I write here 0 upon 8, then this is the 0th part of 8. Here 1 upon 8, that is the 1 part out of 8. And then after 2, then after 3, then after 4, then after 5, then after 6, then after 7, and then after 8 upon 8. So you can also write this as 1. Why? Because 8 ones are 8, and here it is half, 1/2, 4 2s are 8, so 1/2, that also you can write. And here there is anything if in the numerator is 0 and anything is in denominator, then your answer will be 0 only. So 0, half, 1. So this is between 0 and 1. This line is between 0 and 1. So first of all, what they have in 3/8 is added to be 4/8. So here, first of all, 3/8, we will take this up to 3/8. So this is 3/8. Okay, students, now we have to add in that 4/8. So we have to add 4 in that. So this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4. So you can see your answer is what? That is 7/8 is your answer. Okay, 7/8 is your answer. Now let us see manually. So that is 3/8 plus 4/8. Okay. So here we don't have to take the LCM. Why? Because the denominator is same. So that is same. So 3 plus 4 upon 8 is equal to 7/8. You can see both the answers are same. Okay, students, if you want to write this, then you can write, and we will move towards next example, that is example number 17. When one rational number is positive, another is negative. So let us see that. So example number 17. That is 4 by 5 and minus 7 by 5. So here we have to find the sum of this. So what we will do? We have to find the sum of this. But here plus minus it will be minus. Here they have told us to find the sum, but plus minus it will be minus. See here, first of all we will do in this manually. So if here the denominator is same, so I can write 4 by 5 plus minus 7 by 5. So then after plus minus it will be minus. So 4 by 5 minus 7 by 5. Then after the denominators are same, so we don't have to take the LCM. So 4 minus 7, okay, and we get our answer, that is 4 minus 7. That is, if I just subtract 7 minus 4, then your answer will be 3. So here it will be minus 3 upon 5 is your answer. Okay, students, and now just drawing a number line. See here. Number line, that is here 0 upon 5, because it is in the denominator 5, so we have to take 5 parts of it. So 0 upon 5, 1 upon 5, 2 upon 5, 3 upon 5, 4 upon 5, 5 upon 5, 6 upon 5, and here we also have to take in minus up to minus 7 upon 5. We have to take this in the minus. Okay, so I forgot that and I have drawn from this, so we have to draw it again. Here minus 8 upon 5, minus 7 upon 5, minus 6 upon 5, minus 5 upon 5. Here minus 5 upon 5, that is minus 1. Why 5 ones are 5, then you will get that is minus 1. Okay. Here minus 4 upon 5, minus 3 upon 5, minus 2 upon 5, minus 1 upon 5, and here 0 upon 5. Here we have reached to the 0 in the number line, and this is minus 1. Now we have to move up to 4 upon 5. So moving forward, that is 1 upon 5, 2 upon 5, 3 upon 5, and here that is 4 upon 5. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to first of all take, we have to add that. So we have to draw from here to 0. Okay, we have to just add that up to where minus 7 upon 5, to where first of all draw by your student, by draw by your own. Here I have just solved this according to the manually. You just take the answer, that is minus 3 upon 5. I am just giving you some time. Okay, have you drawn this, students? First of all, we have to draw upon minus 7 upon 5 to where 4 upon 5. Yes or no, students? Here. Then after what they have said? They have said, this is the answer between, your answer will be there between this. But you can see we have to do minus also. So how we will do minus? I have done one step. This is wrong or right, students? All have drawn this. This is the wrong step, students. Okay. So first of all, what you have to do here? It is given 4 by 5, and you have to take this 0 to 4 by 5. Okay, drawn, and then after you have to go back side. So what we have to do? So starting from here. Okay. Starting from here, how much we have to take up to the -7 by 5? But okay, here we have to count 7 in the minus direction. Here it is given minus, but it is 7, so we have to count 7 from 4 by 5, but in the direction of negative sign. So negative sign is on this side, so you have to take that arrow up to the -7. Okay, sorry, not -7, but 7 times. That is here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you can see this is your answer. Okay, yes or no, students? How many of you just drawn like this? Then it is correct. Okay, after I have just drawn all from here, then many of them do that also. But this is the right method. Here it is given -4 by 5. Then you have to first of all take up to here, and then after it, the negative sign indicates you have to just go towards the negative part of it. So how much? 7 steps. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you will get the answer. Please note down this, students. And moving towards the example number 18. That is -3/4. And -3/4. Here both the signs are negative. So what you will do? Both the signs are negative. Then what we have to do here? First of all, drawing by the number line. See, here I am just drawing a number line. Okay. So first of all, we have to take start from 0. That is 0/4. Okay, here is this side, -1/4, 2/4, 3/4, and from in the negative side, that is -1/4, -2/4, -3/4, -4/4, that is -1, -5/4, -6/4, -7/4. -8/4. Okay. So we have drawn. First of all, they have given -3/4. They have given 3/4, but it is in the negative side. So where is it? So first of all, we have to take this to the -3/4. So 1, 2, 3. It is over here. And then after, we have to add in that. But here is also -3/4. We have to add 3, but in which minus direction? So 1, 2, 3. Then your answer will be -6/4. And let us count manually. So -3/4 plus in the bracket -3/4. Okay. So now in the next step, माइनस थ्री अपॉन फोर माइनस प्लस माइनस थ्री अपॉन फोर. ओके सो हियर इट विल बी डिनोमिनेटर आर सेम सो माइनस थ्री दैट इज माइनस माइनस प्लस बट द साइन विल रिमेन माइनस सो माइनस थ्री प्लस थ्री सिक्स सो इट इज माइनस सिक्स अपॉन फोर इज अवर आंसर. प्लीज नोट डाउन दिस स्टूडेंट्स. And here you can see now new topic, that is when one denominator is a multiple of the another denominator. In that you can see example number 19a, in that you can see 3 upon 7 plus 5 upon 14. So you can see 7 is a multiple of 14. Okay, so 7 twos are 14. So here they have told us when one denominator is a multiple of another denominator. So let us see example number 7. So what should I multiply by 7, then I will get 14. Okay, so I will say 3 upon 7 into 2, that is 7 twos are 14. So I also have to multiply this in the numerator, so plus 5 upon 14. Okay, so 3 into 2, that is 6 upon 14 plus 5 upon 14, and now you know that how to solve. So denominator is same, so 14, 6 plus 5, that is 11 upon 14 is our answer. And the B is B, that is 3 upon 4 plus minus 7 upon 8, and C is minus 5 by 6 plus minus 3 by 24. Let us calculate this. Okay, here you can see 4 twos are 8, 6 4s are 24, and here you can find the equivalent fraction also, that is given in your book, but I am just taking the another method. Okay, here what should I multiply with 4, so I will get 8, that is 2, so we have to multiply this also in the numerator, then plus minus 7 upon 8. Okay, then our next step will be 3 to the 6 upon 8 plus minus 7 upon 8. Okay, here plus minus minus 6 by 8 minus 7 by 8. So here it will be 8, 6 minus 7, that is minus 1 by 8 is our answer. Please note down this, students. And The next one, in that we know that 6 into 4, that is 24. So minus 5 by 6 into 4 into 4 plus minus 3 by 24. Okay, now our next step will be minus 20 upon 24 plus minus 3 upon 24. So minus 20 plus 24 minus 3 upon 24. So here minus minus it will be plus, but here you can see 24 minus 20 upon minus, sorry, minus 20 minus 3, minus minus plus, but the sign will remain minus. So that is minus 23 upon 24 is our answer. Okay, in your today's homework, what you have to do is homework. You have to do is exercise 4C. Yes, 4C, question number 1 and 2, that you have to do. Okay, students, we will meet in the next video. Okay, bye, students.